Hello everyone and welcome to the Stream TIG channel. So for today's video guys, subject is gonna be about amperage and how only 5 amps can make a big difference on the wood pass. So here for the pipe, 6 inch SCAD 40, just gonna show a little bit about prep. This is how the pipe's supposed to look like. It doesn't matter if you fit it by yourself or a pipe fitter is doing for you. Always gotta be clean, in and out, remove any contamination is going to affect your weld. For the gap, I'm using 532 1/8 rod as a reference. The length, I like feather edge for you, it all depends. Good tools to have, high-low gauge. We're going to give you exact if you got to fix a little bit, do some little bit adjustment with your fitting. And this is barely even 1 mil. So for the tech, it's gonna be a bridge tech, but first I'm gonna do a little commercial.
Hey guys, let me introduce you to TIG sleeve. This is TIG rod storage tube, a special design for TIG welders. Every unit is handcrafted, features an O-ring seal to protect your TIG rods from moisture, dust and any damage. It's a clear anodized aviation grade finish. Includes a durable adjustable strap, that's for comfort and convenience. It's a 360 rotation. You can stretch it out up to 57 inches, so it's gonna fit even 4X guys. It's built to perform, 37 inches in length, so it's gonna fit full-size TIG rods, weighing just 2.6 pounds with a 10-pound rod capacity. Strap it over your back to stay mobile and hands-free while you're climbing, crawling. Comes in 5 different colors and you can check it out on tigsleeve.com.
And for the tack, I'm using 1/4 inch round bar, 110, 115 amps. Nothing fancy, as long as you stay inside that bevel as much as you can, if you don't go up on a surface. 3 tacks on 12, 3 and 9 o'clock. The gap is pretty much consistent all the way around. It's a controlled environment. This is for educational purposes. In the field, it's something different, but still, you wanna have consistent gap pretty much on any joint. Doesn't matter controlled or uncontrolled environment. And the pipe has to be clean and good prep, and that's most crucial. Okay, so for tungsten, 1/8. 1/8 tungsten and cup. Usually I was sticking religiously to cup size 8. This is cup 11. Pretty much I'm gonna do a freehand, so it doesn't really matter. I just want to have a little bit better arc flow. And for the TIG wire, 1/8 7S6. So the idea here, like for the back feet technique, you want to keep it inside a little bit above that edge, above the surface. And this is going to be, I'm going to do 4 sections with 4 different amperage. It's going to be only 5 increments different. We're going to start with 120 and we're going to go all the way down to 105. And then I'm gonna show you how the only 5 amps makes different on your route. And for this one, I picked to do with choose to do it with a back feet technique. As you can see here, so this is 120. I'm holding that rod, let's say couple mils above that route. It's connected right to the edge of your puddle, and with 120 in this case, also depends from the welding machine. Every welding machine is behaving a little bit different on a different amperage, different settings. So for this one, as you can see, it's burning faster, so you gotta feed it faster. That's how you already have a little bit heavier root. Especially, this is the most crucial part. So if you can handle it's very important your travel speed, your feeding hand, and the amperage. So it depends how much you can handle, how fast you can feed. If you can adjust your feeding hand with the travel speed and with the amps, then you're gonna have a little bit heavier buildup here. And as you can see now, if I go all the way up, and if I apply the same technique, just holding inside a couple mils, it'll be a little bit heavy, especially on the side from when you're going up 4 to 3 o'clock. It'll be a little bit heavier buildup. So we're gonna go down five amps, and I'm gonna do a bottom section from 6 to 8 o'clock. So the same thing, back feed, couple mils above that root connected to the edge of the liquid puddle. Just gotta keep it connected. Same thing, depends how fast your rod is burning, depends on your inclination of your tungsten. You gotta feed that hand, but still, now you can see the already difference. The profile is a little bit lower than 120 amps. So even if you're in a field, guys, if you 120 and then you see, you know, like it's burning too fast, you gotta really feed fast. Slow down, stop right away, slow down, go down 5 amps. That's why we always say in the field, you know, up 5, down 5. 5 is a magic number. So this is 115 amps. The bottom, it's a little bit lower profile. When I'm going up, it's a little bit getting heavier, but that's when you gotta push that rod closer inside that root. Okay, now 110 for this section. Now we're gonna go from 3 o'clock all the way to 12. And as you go up on the top, you don't have to, you can always pull it out a little bit. You don't have to hold it inside, but just for educational purposes, this is a back feed. So I'm gonna just hold it inside. Now you see with 110, it's even lower profile, even though I'm using the same technique. So the back feed, the rod is connected from the inside, I'm not pulling out, and it's already, it's a little bit shallow, and you can see it's getting like a flat in some spaces. Still, I have a little profile, it's not flush. So this is already 10 amps different from the initial root from the first one. Okay, now we're gonna go 105, and I'm gonna do from 9 o'clock all the way to 12. Same thing, holding them from inside, doing back feed. Okay, so this is a 105, and you can see already the difference. Now it's already lower profile. There is a little bit buildup, a little bit uniform, but this in some cases, you know, that's why people got lots of issues when a root is flash. Either travel speed or your amperage settings, and which can be a problem later when you're doing hot pass, you can have a suck back. That's why I always like to go, I always like to have the little bit heavier profile on my root passes, as you can see here. So from here, this is 120 amps all the way to here. You can see a little bit heavier build up here. Later, I mean, if you can, you can continue on with 120, but you gotta pull it out inside that bevel. Don't hold it strictly inside, like what I was showing here on for the back feed. This is 115, This is usually profile that I like have on my roots. You don't have to worry for sagbacks later. This one 110, as you can see, nothing's wrong with this profile as well. You got enough meat inside. There shouldn't be any problems for the sagback, especially if you're going the 332, let's say, for the hot pass, and this is 105. You can see this is absolutely different than all three others. Still a little bit profiled inside, which also nothing's wrong with it. It all depends later from your hot pass. Like if you don't want to really have a big sag back, use a 332 rod, and don't go too much with amps. Just maybe 10, 20 more than what you were doing for your root pass. And that's it. Pretty much, I want to show you guys just a 5 amp difference can have a big impact on your root pass. Hope you like it. Hope you enjoyed the share and like. And see you in the next one. Bye.